and welcome back, live main event from Daytona Beach. I'm Eric Bischoff, along with the Macho Man Randy Savage, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, and this is what it's all about, guys. Who is it going to be from the Dungeon of Doom? Someone is going to step in there with the WCW World Heavyweight Champion Hulk Hogan.
All the chips are down now. We got to see the down cards. Taskmaster, you want to tell us anything before? But now it happens. Let's see what you got, Dusty.
Well, I believe the emotional state of Hulk Hogan is going to be found out in just a few seconds, but the bottom line, Eric Bischoff and the Macho Man Randy Savage, is you can call a man out one-on-one and say, I want to fight you right now, but when you call out five of them and don't know which one is coming out, it remains to be seen. Feathers going to fly, brother, and it's going to break loose right here on the main event.
Ooh.
As we count down to the Clash of the Champions, who is it going to be from the Dungeon of Doom? We are about to find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the WCW main event. Coming to the ring at this time in the company of the Taskmaster of the Dungeon of Doom, Kevin Sullivan, a man who weighs 380 pounds. From the jungles of Uganda, he's a member of the Dungeon of Doom, a group dedicated to the destruction and the worldwide purging of Hulkamania. Ladies and gentlemen, the Ugandan warrior, Kamala!
Well, there you have it, the Macho Man Randy Savage, Dusty Rhodes, we've seen it. It is going to be Kamala, the Ugandan warrior, stepping into the ring with the WCW World Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, Eric Bischoff, I believe that the choice by the Taskmaster was something to throw Hulk Hogan off more than he is, and this is the most unorthodox man, Macho Man Randy Savage, in wrestling.
All right, we'll have the match right after this.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Kamala's opponent, wearing yellow and red, and weighing 274 pounds, coming in with his manager, the mouth of the South, the legendary Jimmy Hart. He's one of the most famous athletes in the world today, a living legend in the world of pro wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, from Venice Beach, California, the King of Hulkamania, presenting the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, Hulk Hogan!
All right, Hulk Hogan with his game face on, and if there was anybody that had any doubts in her mind whether or not Hulk Hogan was emotionally ready to take on the Dungeon of Doom, those questions have been answered.
He's gonna let it fly!
Well, he wanted one, he's got one. That's what we got right here on the main event, because Kamala has seized the moment.
I got one question from the Macho Man Randy Savage and for the American Dream. In my opinion, this is bait, because Hulk Hogan has to step into the Dungeon of Doom later on at the Clash of the Champions. Maybe this is just overconfidence. Maybe this is just a Taskmaster setting Hogan up.
But at the same time, he's got to cross this first hurdle before he can get to the Dungeon of Doom. This is where the chips are down, and he's a clutch hitter, but he's still got to touch all bases.
Boy, look at this, a big slam. I tell you, Kamala, I mean, being right is what he's got to do right now. Hogan's up. Look at that, Eric.
Hulk Hogan at the top of his game, and Kamala has never seen anything like this before. The Hulkster hammering away at Kamala, and Kamala goes down.
Hulkster hasn't lost his pizzazz.
Absolutely not. You know, the emotion that we've seen on Hulk Hogan over the last couple of weeks, one would have to wonder if he was on top of his game or not, but he is wound tighter than I've ever seen him.
Well, as you said a while ago, the battles have to be won before the war is won. This is battle number one against the Ugandan warrior, Kamala. Go ahead and hit him right on the head.
Hulk Hogan getting ready to step into the Dungeon of Doom later on at the Clash of the Champions. You're also going to see six men, or I should say five men and one woman, tag team action as Harlem Heat and Sister Sherry get into the thick of things with Colonel Parker Slater and Buck, that's coming your way. Arn Anderson, Ric Flair taking on Vader, but right now the WCW World Heavyweight Champion with his hands full.
What an attitude Hulk Hogan has right now. And I'm going to tell you something right now. I like it. He's holding nothing back.
Yeah, he can't hold anything back because he declared war, and right now he's got to go ahead and finish this one off and get to the rest of them. And he's got Kamala reeling and rocking, baby.
Hulk Hogan now going after the Ugandan warrior. Kamala coming off the ropes, and that's a lot of weight coming off those ropes at about 40 miles an hour.
This is no gimme right here, Kamala the Ugandan giant. He's going all over the world, and Hulk Hogan, he's got to make a statement tonight, right now, before going into the Dungeon of Doom. His back's against the wall. Look at this.
Hey, ref, look at this.
With that cane or whatever it is.
It's a staff.
It's a what?
The staff, am I right or wrong?
You're right. I'm not going to argue with you anyway, even if you were wrong.
Yeah, it's a staff, all right, and he got it right in his throat, but what set it up was Kamala caught him coming off the rope. Give him one to the throat, then give him two to the throat, and then the staff came into play, and now Kamala's back on the offense.
Now, this is what scares me. Are they trying to hurt Hogan? Maybe it's not about winning or losing. They're going to try to hurt Hogan here, so when he steps into that Dungeon of Doom, anything can happen. And I've talked to a couple of people who've said that that giant is over 7'4" tall. I haven't been close to him, but this is one huge human being.
We're not just talking about physically now. We're talking about emotionally, because that underlying current of the story that he told at Bash at the Beach could be the defining factor.
I guarantee it. The Taskmaster could care less whether Kamala wins this thing or not. He wants Hogan hurt. He wants damaged goods going into the Dungeon of Doom.
Remember that the world title's not on the line. The Taskmaster has a different agenda.
That's a great point right there, but I tell you what, here comes Hulk Hogan and the Hulkamanians and the millions around the world. This is what drives this legendary hero right here.
This floor's shaking.
The more you hit him, the more he loves it. Hulk Hogan now with an Irish whip. The Ugandan warrior coming across, and a big boot right at the top of the chest.
That's it. That's it.
See you later. Goodbye.
Look at the Taskmaster.
Yes. All right. Give him the ride, baby.
I've been waiting to see this.
Uh-oh. It is a plan. I'm out of here.
Randy, what are you?
Looks like a shark attack.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage, has just bailed up from the broadcast table.
Go get him, Macho.
As the Stinger makes his way to the ring.
Something, Eric, they wanted war, and they got war, and the battle lines have been evened up. The men have been evened up, and brother, it has exploded right here in Daytona.
The winner by disqualification, the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan stood his ground with the Ugandan warrior, and then we saw everyone but, and I mean everyone but, the Giant.
Well, I'll tell you what, and I think that's what everybody is waiting and wanting to see. Where was the Giant? But they brought it all from the Dungeon of Doom. And the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and Sting came down there. Brother, run. The Macho Man jumped right out of this protest. He just ran down there. I love it. I tell you what, Eric. The excitement has just started tonight, my friend.
Absolutely just started. I'll tell you what, the Macho Man came out of his chair and did about a 60-yard sprint in less time than it takes to say it. And by the time he got there, Sting was already there. Hogan, Sting, Macho Man took control of the situation. But Dusty Rhodes, the question I have, the obvious, the Giant wasn't there. That tells me something about the Dungeon of Doom coming up later on at the Clash of the Champions. Because, yes, Hulk Hogan's healthy. Hulk Hogan's on his own 2 feet. But he has got to step right into the Dungeon of Doom. And that's a serious situation.
Well, he's got to feel that something is left undone. And you just laid it on the line. The Giant has yet to make his intentions known, brother.
All right, now I know Mean Gene Okerlund is going to do his best to get comments from Hogan, Savage, Sting.
You know, I tell you what, Eric, it's hard sometimes to get comments when you're in a fighting mode, and that Hulkamania, Hulk Hogan, is in a fighting mode,
He's wanting the war to continue. He's an electrified country, has electrified Daytona Beach, and is working his way back right now. And I'm going to tell you what, right here, brother, he dropped him. He had him done, but he sent that old, the taskmaster for the ride, and then, excuse me, but all hell broke loose.
All right, it looks to me like Mean Gene Okerlund is just about ready. Let's pass it on down.
All right, Eric, thank you very much. This is War Hulk Hogan. This has got to mean we will see you later in the Clash in the Dungeon of Doom.
Well, I guess you could say the party's over, brother. Hulk Hogan officially declared war on the Dungeon of Doom. And I got the Hulkster's war paint on right now. Boom shakalaka-laka, boom shakalaka. Come on, as far as the Shark, as far as the Zodiac, as far as Kevin Sullivan, what you just saw out there is the beginning. That is nothing, brother, because me and Gene, I got a date with the Dungeon of Doom tonight, brother. And I'm going to finish right where I left off with all those goons, because I got some maniacs watching my back, brother.
You are a good puppet.
That's right. The Hulkster, the Macho Man, from now on, we are going to be the eyes in back of the Hulkster's head. Woo!
That was just a little itsy-bitsy message to the Taskmaster and the Master. This man is going in the Dungeon of Doom in a little while. Oh, yeah. And let all hell break loose.
Oh, yeah.
All right, any concern, any trepidation, Hulk?
Yeah. We're scared to death, Kevin Sullivan. I know about what's etched in stone as far as Hulk Hogan's future. And I've been living with a nightmare. I've been living with the fear, but with the maniacs by my side, brother. The Dungeon of Doom, the pythons are pumped beyond enormous preparations. I got the war paint on, brother. Like I said, they're watching my back. So when I hit that Dungeon of Doom, war has been declared. And what you gonna do when the maniacs run wild all over you, brother? What you gonna do?
Coming up, the Clash of the Champions!